Welcome back, students. We were seeing the topic about respiration, respiration in animals and plants. In last session, we have learned about the breathing, two steps that are breathing and respiration, that is external respiration as well as the internal respiration. Now, in this session, we will see about the types and modes of respiration. The first type of respiration is the aerobic respiration. Now, what is aero? First of all, aero means air, and air mostly consists of oxygen. So the aerobic respiration means that is carried out in the presence of oxygen, right? So whenever you will hear aerobic respiration in presence of oxygen, so mainly the living organisms like animals, plants, or you can say human beings, all the organisms mainly which consume food, or you can say that means when they there is intake of food, that food is in the form of glucose which is oxidized and leading to the release of carbon dioxide. So ultimately what happens in aerobic respiration, the food is digested, or you can say the energy is released from the food in the presence of oxygen. So that is aerobic respiration. One, what is the site of aerobic respiration? Site is mitochondria. Respiration or obviously takes place in the cells, and in the cells it takes place in mitochondria. This is a cell. If we'll consider, mitochondria is a part of cell where this aerobic respiration takes place, and finally the energy is released outside the cell. Next type is the anaerobic respiration. That means complete opposite of aerobic respiration, which takes place in the absence of oxygen. So you can just consider that the organisms which do not breathe in oxygen, like you can say without oxygen, that means mainly the yeast cells can be involved as well as the bacteria. And you know, in aerobic respiration the energy is released, okay, the energy is released. And again, next thing is that CO2 and water is formed, right, in aerobic respiration. While in anaerobic respiration, what happens, the glucose, that means the food which you are taking, that is converted into alcohol. The glucose is converted into alcohol plus CO2, and the energy is released. So in anaerobic respiration, this is the difference, that glucose when is utilized or oxidized, the alcohol is formed, carbon dioxide is released, as well as the energy is obtained. So energy is released, that is the main you can say process of respiration, release of energy. But when it occurs in presence of oxygen CO2 and water are the byproducts, then it is aerobic respiration, and it takes place in the mitochondria of the living organisms. While in anaerobic respiration, what happens, that the organisms which survive in the absence of oxygen release alcohol and carbon dioxide and also the energy. So, and mostly the yeast cells, or you can say the bacteria, are the examples for this, right? Now, what are the different types of modes of transmission? You know, there are different animals in our environment and different organisms, and different organisms have different methods of taking air and giving out carbon dioxide. Now what happens is that you can consider the living things, like frogs have different mode of respiration, fish, and that is, you can say that is an amphibian, okay, like this is an aquatic animal. Again, living on the land, like human beings which live on land, they have different modes of transmission. Like most of the time they respire through lungs, okay. Now we can see in the picture here that fish utilizes its gills. Gills are nothing but a large number of filaments present over the, you can say the part of the body of the fish which have gills. Now as water enters the mouth of the fish, and flows over the gills, the oxygen is dissolved in the water, is absorbed by the blood when the capillaries, and carbon dioxide is given out. Now human beings cannot absorb the oxygen dissolved in water, so they need to carry the oxygen in their tanks and respire. And so the divers have to carry their oxygen, you know, in the tank and respire under the water. Next comes the examples of the frog. You know, frog can also be said the can be also called that they undergo skin or cutaneous respiration, because they respire, you know, they use more than one organ for respiration. They can respire from nostrils also, from mouth cavity, then it goes to lungs, then from skin also they can respire. So this considers that this frog undergo cell membrane, or you can say or skin, as well as this also. Amoeba also, it also respire through cell membrane. So that means this bacteria goes cell membrane respiration, while frog can undergo skin or cutaneous respiration. So okay, you can also say that entire body surface also helps in the exchange of the gases, right? Next comes, though, you can also take the example of insect. It respire through a tracheoles and all, especially the spiracles, right? It utilizes the spiracles, this insect. Take the example of this grasshopper, it respired through spiracles. Next, some of the human beings respire through lungs. So, different organisms have different modes of respiration. So, students, in this session, we have seen the types and modes of respiration. In next session, we'll see the respiration carried out in animals and plants. Thank you.